ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ शं नो मित्रश्यं वरुणः शं नो भवत्वर्यमा शं न इन्द्रो बृहस्पतिः शं नो विष्णुरुरुक्रमः नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स् वी आर् रीडिङ्ग् दि भाष्यम् अण्डर् The ninth anuvaka of Brahmavalli, that is Anandavalli of Taittiriya Upanishad. We have read in the last class, we read the mantra, we also read part of the Bhashyam. I think we will be able to complete the Bhashyam and then move on to say the Bhrigu Valli also, that is the third Valli today. So in the this particular Valli was saying, Yato Vacho Nivartante, that is how it started. The person who realizes that Brahman's bliss, the bliss of Brahman, he is not scared from anything. In the earlier Anuvaka, that is in the fourth Anuvaka, Anabibheti Kadachana, that is, he is not afraid at any time. That is, only fear was excluded there. But now, the difference between Kadachana and Kutaschana, Shankaracharya was explaining in the last line, which we read in the last class. That is, he was saying, Kadachana, by saying Nabibheti Kadachana, only fear is excluded. Nabibheti Kutaschana, from anybody, which means that he is not seeing any duality. This person, the person who has realized that Brahman's bliss, he is seeing oneness everywhere, and then he is not seeing any duality. Because he is not seeing any duality, he is not afraid from anybody, from anything, Kutaschana. So that is where we stopped. And then the last line we read was, Nabibheti kutaschaneti, bhayanimittam eva pratishidhyate. The very cause of fear, bhayanimittam eva, the very cause of fear has been dismissed. So that is the point there. Then, let us read, Nan vasti bhayanimittam, sadhvakaranam papakriyacha. So this is regarding this line. Etakam havana tapati kimaham sadhuna karavam kimaham papam akaravam iti. So that was the line. For that line we are seeing the Bhashyam. So it is okay. You are not afraid of anything. But then what about your own action? Your own actions of sins of commission and omission. Your own omissions are there. Your own commissions are there. So what about those things? That baggage is there. So that is what is the question. The Purvapakshi says, Nanu, Asti bhaya nimittam. No, is it not so? No. Is it not so that bhaya nimittam is very much there? What is that? Sadhu akaranam. That is non-performance of good deeds and papa kriyacha, performance of bad things. Not doing good and doing bad. So, is it not so? So, the Siddhanti replies, Naivam. Katham ityuchyate. Etam yathoktam evam vidam.
न तपति न उद्वेजयति न संतापयति
कथं पुनः
साध्वकरणं पापक्रियाच
तपति इत्युच्यते
न तपति
ओके दैट आल्सो कैन बी सेड Tapati ityuchyate, it depends on anvaya. Na tapati ityuchyate. Kim kasmat? No, it need not be there. Because here, katham punaha sadhvakaranam papakriyacha tapati. Otherwise, for a normal person, the sadhu akaranam and papakriya, they do torment him from inside. They do cause agony. they do burn him from inside. So that is it. So that na need not be there. Katham punaha sadhvakaranam papakriya cha tapati ityuchyate kim kasmat sadhu shobhanam karma na akaravam.
Sadhu shobhanam karma na akaravam.
Na kurtavan asmiti.
Na kurtavan asmiti.
Paschat santapo bhavati.
Paschat santapo bhavati.
Asanne maranakale.
Asanne maranakale.
So that is, it is actually the occurrence of fear, occurrence of that. Inside internal torment, internal anguish or agony, which burns a person from inside. So that is it. So, naivam, it is not so. Katham ityushyate. How is it? That is being told. Etam means this particular person. Etoktam evam vidam. We are talking about this evam with. This person, Mr. Evam with, the person who knows, who has realized Brahman in this manner. Then, havava ityva avadharanarthav. Etagam havana tapati, that is the line, havava. You remember that ushan havaiva jashravasaha. Indeed, is it not so? So that is what it means, havava. It is so well known. Havava iti avadharanarthav. In order to emphasize, avadharana is basically to emphasize. Then, na tapati na udvejayati. It does not, this particular question does not burn him. Tapati, tapadhatu. To agitate, to burn, to make you take any meaning. In fact, burning seems to be a better thing. The actual meaning of tapa also is to burn. Surya tapam, chanda, so like that. Surya tapam, agni tapam, so tapati. Agni hi tapati, surya tapati. So tapadhatu, it burns. That udvejayati, it doesn't agitate him. What? This question. Na santapayati. It doesn't make him, it doesn't give him grief. Na santapayati. Santapa means grief. It doesn't cause anguish. It doesn't cause grief. Then katham punaha sadhvakaranam papakriyasya tapati. So how is it that this sadhu akaranam, that is non-performance of good deeds and doing of bad deeds, how do they burn a man or how do they agitate, how do they torment a man from inside? In this way. Kim kasmat, kim means kim aham papam, kim aham sadhuna karam, kim means kasmat, why? Kim is, the meaning is kasmat, why? Sadhu shobhanam karma, sadhu means good, sadhu is good. Sadhu karma is shobhanam karma, good activity, like something which is recommended in our, say, Puranas, let us say. Suppose you take some Purana, now it is Kartika Masa, so in Kartika Masa you have to do some fasting or something like that. You have to go to some Shiva temple, you have to light some lamp. So all these things are prescribed in this, say, month. Suppose you feel, in this Kartika Masa I did not, say, go to Shiva temple at all, I did not do fast at all, I did not light a lamp at all, or I did not do any pilgrimage to Tirupati or some other place. So these are all things which are normally good deeds which are expected. Or I did not give any donation, I was a miserly person, I did not do this good thing. So various things which are usually recommended for the purpose of attaining punya. So this is something which torments a man at what time? Asanne marana kale. Na kutavanasmiti paschat santapo bhavati asanne marana kale. Marana kale asanne sati. When that time of departure has come, when that time of death has come, then paschat santapaha bhavati. We use the word called paschattapam. Paschattapa is, paschat means later, tapam means agony. Paschattapam means agony, later agony which we have later. Paschat santapaha, he has only used one upasarga, added one upasarga, some upasarga. Paschattapaha, paschat santapaha, that is, sadness after a particular thing. So at the time of death, there is a sort of sadness in this man. Why I did not do any good thing? Why I did all these bad things? Kimaham shobhanam karma na karavam? Why did I not do? Na krutavan asmi? Iti paschat santapaha bhavati asanne maranakale. This type of santapa exists in a person. Why I did not do this good thing? Why I did not do fast? So all these things, they torment a person. A normal person. We are talking about a normal person. How this papakriya, how these two things, agitate a person or cause sadness in a person, that is being explained. Then similarly, tatha, kim kasmat,
kim kasmat,
papam pratishuddham karma akaravam kurtavanasmi iti cha. इति च नरकपतनादि दुःखभयात् तापो भवति. सो दिस् तापः भवति, सैड्नेस् हेपन्स्. हौ तथा किं, कस्मात्, वै, पापं प्रतिषिद्धं कर्म, सं प्रतिषिद्ध कर्म ऐ हेव् कमिटेड्. सो दिस् टैप् आफ् से मिसरी, दिस् टैप् आफ् मिसरी इस् देर् इन् दि मैण्ड् आफ् ए पर्सन् हू इस् अप्रोचिङ्ग् डेत्. किं पापं कर्म अकरवम् इति नरकपतनादि दुःखभयात्. It is not because of anything else. It is not that he is repenting because it is something which is bad. The fear is that he is going to hell. The other thing is he is not going to heaven. For a normal person, he thinks, had I done this karma, I would have gone to Shivaloka, I would have gone to Vishnuloka. Now I cannot go. Then on the other hand, I have done this particular bad thing. I am likely to go to Naraka. So all these things, this type of fear will be there, in that person.
Te ete.
Sadhvakarana papakriye.
Evam enam na tapataha.
Yatha avidvamsam tapataha. Te ete means te is not plural here. Te is dvivachana. Papakarma, punyakarma, tat te tani. So te ete. This ete also is the same thing. Etat ete. What are these two things? Sadhu akarana papakriye. This is also in vivachana. That is not doing good and doing bad. Sadhu akarana papakriya cha. Evam, in this manner, enam na tapataha. Enam means brahmavidam. Evam vit, this enam means this particular person. Who is this person? This evam vit, the person who has realized. Enam na tapataha. Tapataha is dvivachana. Tapati. It is in dvivachana, prathama vibhakti dvivachana. Tapataha. These two questions, they do not agitate him. That is the meaning. These two questions, why I did not do a good thing, why I did a bad thing, these two things, they do not agitate him. Yatha avidvamsam tapataha. They do torment an avidvan, but then they do not torment a vidvan. This realized person is not tormented, an unrealized person is tormented. Why is it that a realized person is not tormented? We are going to see. कस्मात् पुनः विद्वांसं न तपतः इत्युच्यते. सः एवं विद्वान् एते साध्वसाधुनि तापहेतु इति आत्मानं स्पृणुते प्रीणयति बलयति वा. परमात्मभावेन उभे पश्यति इत्यर्थः. ओके, वै इज इट दट दिस पुण्यम एंड पापम डू नॉट टॉर्मेंट हिम. सो दट इज द क्वेश्चन. दिस पुण्यम एंड पापम, द आइडिया ऑफ पुण्य एंड पाप, दे डू नॉट टॉर्मेंट द रियलाइज्ड पर्सन. दिस एवं विथ वै कथम कस्मात् पुनः, वै इज इट दैट विद्वांसम ए रियलाइज पर्सन न तपतः. दीज टू क्वेश्चन दे डोंट से एजिटेट हिम. वै स एवं विद्वान, दिस पर्टिकुलर द वन हू नोस एवं विद्वान. एवं विद्वान मीन्स एवं वित्. स एवं वित् द पर्सन हू नोस इन दिस वे. एते साध्व साधुनी ताप हेतु इति. दिस साधु एंड असाधु कर्म, this non-performance of good thing and performance of something bad, these two things, they are tapa hetu. These are the causes of tapa. These are the causes of grief. Iti pashyan, we have to borrow that word. Iti pashyan, otherwise the sentence will not be complete. Iti pashyan. Seeing like that, by noticing like that, or considering them like that. So that is the meaning. Iti pashyan. Atmanam sprunute prinayati. He actually strengthens. He pleases the Atma. He strengthens the Atma. We have seen the meaning of this word sprunute. Spru in Preeti Palanayoho is the meaning. Preeti Palanayoho. That is creating happiness. Preenayati means he makes something else happy. Preenayati. That is making someone else happy. not becoming happy. Prinayati is making someone else happy. Then balayati, that is making someone else strong. Then who is this someone else? Atman. Atmanam prinayati. He strengthens the self. He makes the self happy. In the sense that he is more strongly aware of his own self. He is more strongly settled in his state of awareness, in his state of pure consciousness, pure awareness. So that is what we have to see. In what way is it strengthening him? Because he is not able to see this punya and papa as some nuisance. Otherwise, the punyam and papam, they cause nuisance. They torment a man. They burn a man from inside. They burn the person's mind from inside. But whereas a realized person, he doesn't see them like that. He just sees them as this tapahetu. Oh, these two things are the tapahetu. And then I have gone beyond them. So because a realized person, he is not bothered about performing a, he may do, he may go to a pilgrimage, he may go for a pilgrimage, he may go to a temple, he may do all the things which other people do, but then he doesn't suffer from any guilt feeling in case he doesn't do that. Suppose you don't go to temple today, you need not be very, very guilty. Suppose you are reading Gita or you are reading Shankara Bhashya and then you have not performed your, going to a temple or something else. So you need not, you will not feel so guilty. Otherwise, an ignorant man, he will feel that he has done such a great sin. So that will be tormenting him. So that sort of torment will not be there in the mind of an enlightened man. So he is more strong in his own self. So that is the meaning. Atmanam prinayati means, it is not as though there is one person called Atma who is becoming happy and all that. Atmanam prinayati means he is more happy in himself. He is settled in himself. He is stronger in his awareness. So that is it. Prinayati, balayativa. He is stronger in his awareness. Balayativa. How? Paramatma bhavena ube pasyati. He sees both these things as not different from Paramatma. He sees both punyam and papam as just manifestations in this Paramatma. For this, of course, Anandagiri gives a small vyakhya. I'll just read out. Because otherwise in the normal way, how we do understand? Jnani, we have seen in the Gita also. For Jnani, there is no Kartrutva. He goes beyond Kartrutva. He may be doing certain things like King Janaka. King Janaka, he is ruling the kingdom. He is doing various activities like rewarding good people and then punishing bad people, etc., etc. He is doing so many welfare things and all that. But all those things, they don't touch him. Because in a jnani, that karma becomes karma abhasa. It is only karma for name's sake, but the fruit of that karma does not touch him. Karma abhasa. So that is what we have seen him. We have seen there. So the papa karma, there is no question of papa karma touching him. And there is no question of punya karma also touching him. So he has gone beyond that good and evil. And then before he became enlightened, he had done something bad, let us say. Before he became enlightened, he had done something bad. All that also is gone because jnanagni dagdha karmani. So once a person is enlightened, his punyam and papam and the entire baggage of sanchita karma, they all vanish. So that is the point. So that way also it can be explained. But Anandagiri explains in a slightly different way, saying that this Anandagiri Tika, I'll just read out. Sadhu asadhuni staha. That is, this sadhu and asadhu, that is good and bad do things, they do exist. Staha. Staha means they do exist. Prakashetecha. That is, they also manifest. So we know one sloka called Asti Bhati Priyam Rupam Namaj Nama Chet Yamsha Panchakam, isn't it? Asti Bhati Priyam, these three and Nama Rupa. Adhyatrayam Brahma Rupam Jagadrupam Tato Dvayam. So that sloka from Panchadashi, we know that. So there, almost the same thing he says here. See, this punyam and papam also, they also exist and then they do appear, isn't it? But then the so-called nama and rupa, punyam, papam, etc., they are unreal. So you see them paramatma bhavena, like you see every being as existence and consciousness. A person, a jnani, he sees every other being also as not different from that supreme existence. So this chit and sat, these two amshas, they are common, isn't it? This chit and sat are common. The name and form, it is something which is vishesha. It is an attribute. The name and form is something which is agantuka, it is attribute. Chit and sat are something which are eternal. Chit and sat are which are the common factors, isn't it? So sadhva sadhuni staha prakashete cha iti sat prakashamatram atmatattvam eva tayo swarupam. This is sat prakashamatram, this existence and appearance, manifestation, they are their only swarupam. Tato atiriktam yada arthanartha hetutvam nama vishesha rupam. So tato vyatiriktam, that is tato atiriktam. Beyond that, the names and forms which are there, that is something which is agantukam. It is not something, it's a swarupa. Name and form, like you take our own case. In our own case, the asti bhati, priyam, these are the common factors, these are the things which are there in everything. Name and form, they are just incidental, they are the vishesha rupa. So that is how he explains. So he sees, a jnani sees these punya papa also in the same manner. He sees them, he dismisses the names and forms, and then he sees them as not different from Brahman. It's a slightly complicated explanation, but in a more, shastriya, in accordance with the scriptural logic and all that, more logical, explanation he gives. So, punya paramatma bhavena ubhe pasyati ityarthaha. Then, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
It's clear, isn't it?
Yes.
Ubhe punya pape.
He yasmat.
Yesha vidvan. Okay. Evam yesha vidvan. Ete atmanam atma rupena iva. Punya pape. Svena vishesha rupena shunye kurtva. Atmanam sprunuta eva. So this gentleman, who is this evam with, how does he see them? He sees the common thing in them, that is asti bhati, that common swarupam only he sees in them, by negating the vishesha rupa. Vishesha rupa shunyekrutva. Shunyekrutva means by emptying the vishesha rupa. It is as though you and I, we are emptied of our names and forms. If we are emptied of our names and forms, what is remain is asti bhati, isn't it? Priyam. So, that is how he does it. Ubhe punya pape. What is this line we are seeing? Ubhe hye vaishayete atmanagas prunute. That line. Ubhe hi means because. In the earlier line he said, he is strengthening the soul. Not soul, he is strengthening the atma, self. Then, he again says, why? Why is it so? Because these two things called punyam and papam, this esha vidvan, evam esha vidvan, your book says evam also, in this manner this particular scholar or this particular enlightened person, ete means punya pape, this ete connect to punya pape, these two punyam and papam, atmanam atma rupena iva, atmanam sprunute means atma rupena iva. Svikaroti. Atma rupena iva pasyati. So that is what it means. Svena vishesha rupena shunye kurtva. That vishesha rupa is there. That names and forms. He dismisses the names and forms. So like he sees these punyam and papam like he sees anything else in the world. That's all. You see, the jnani, he sees anything else in the world as asti and bhati and not as nama rupa. So that is where his happiness lies, isn't it? If he sees names and forms, he sees the difference. Here he is not seeing the names and forms. He is dismissing the names and forms. As in the case of all other beings, he has refused to see an enemy. He has refused to see duality. Likewise, he has also refused to see this thing. Not consciously refused, but by awareness. He is an enlightened person. He does not see duality. Likewise, he also dismisses duality here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Vishesha rupena shunye kurtva, by negating this vishesha rupa, by negating this name and form kurtva, sprunuta eva, atmanam sprunuta eva. He pleases the self, means he is more happy, he is more strong in his self. That is it. He is so strongly aware of, he is strongly in his awareness. Then, kaha. Kaha means who? Who is it that he does like that?
Ya evam veda.
Yathoktam advaitam anandam brahma veda.
Tasya atma bhavena drushte punya pape.
Nirvirye atapake.
nirvirye atapake
janmantara arambhake na bhavata
janmantara arambhake na bhavata
itiyamevam yathokta asyam valyam
brahma vidyopanishat
sarvabhyo vidyabhyah paramarahasyam darshitam ityarthah param shreyo asyam nishannam iti okay, so yeah, who is it that sees like this? Evam Veda, the person who sees like this, who has realized Brahman like this. Yathoktam advaitam anandam brahma veda. This particular Brahma, which has been described as advaitam anandam, this non-dual bliss. So that particular bliss, the one who knows like this, tasya, for that person, atma bhavena drushte punya pape, these two things which are seen, these two things called punyam and papam, which are seen as not different from the self, as not different from the atma, then nirvirye atapake, they become nirvirya, they become powerless, let us say nirvirya. Viryam is power, shakti. Viryam, normal sense of viryam also, strength, power, etc. They become powerless, and then atapake, they cannot torment, they cannot cause any type of sadness, they cannot cause any grief, they do not burn him, they do not agitate him or cause agony in him. Nirvirye atapake janmantararambhake nabhavataha, and they don't create another janma, they don't go to the making of another janma. Normally punyam and papam, what is their purpose? Their purpose is they cause another janma, isn't it? For a normal person, whether it is punyam or papam, it is a baggage. Punyam is a gold bag and then papam is some other bag, but then this baggage he has to carry. So, and because of that baggage he transmigrates, he gets another birth. But here, in this particular case, these punyam and papam, they become nirvirya, they become powerless, they become neutralized, they become sterilized, let us say. And then atapake, they can't cause agony. Na janmantararambhake bhavataha, that is, they do not cause rebirth. And then iti iyam evam, so in this manner, this particular message, yatha ukta, as has been told, in this manner, then asyam valyam, means in this particular valli, this particular meaning, this particular message has been told, valyam. Brahma Vidya Upanishad. This particular thing which has been told is Brahma Vidya. The knowledge of Brahman has been told. Then what is this? Upanishad. Upanishad is Rahasyam. In this sense, Parama Rahasyam. Why? Though it is so clearly it is knowable, usually people do not know. People do not bother to know. Though it is so clear, people do not know it. So that is why it is Rahasyam. Upanishad. Sarvabhyo Vidyabhyaha Parama Rahasyam. That is, this is the supreme secret. This is the supreme secret which has to be preserved. Rahasyam, you can also take it in that sense. Idam tute guhyatamam. There also the meaning of guhyam we have seen. It is something, it is so valuable that it has to be preserved. So in that sense also you can take it as rahasyam. Paramarahasyam, it is the supreme secret. Among all the entire corpus of knowledge, sarvabhyo vidyabhyaha, in the whole corpus of knowledge, this is the parama rahasyam, supreme rahasyam. Darshitam, it has been demonstrated, it has been presented before us. Then param shreyaha asyam nishannam. Asyam means asyam vidyayam, in this particular vidya, supreme shreyaha, that is supreme good, is there. Nishannam means it is there, it is existing there, it is deposited there. Supreme good is there, dwells in this. Supreme good dwells in this particular vidya. So that is the meaning. Supreme good dwells in this vidya. So that is how we conclude this thing. Then we will come to the last Shanti Patha is there. So let us read the Shanti Patha. Om Sahana Avavatu.
Sahana
Avavatu. Sahana Uhunaktu.
Saha
Viryam Karavavahai. Tejasvi Navadhi Tamastu Mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So for this particular Anuvaka, though it is a small Anuvaka, Sureshwaracharya has written a very huge Vartika. Of course, he has summarized the whole Valli. We cannot go into all these details because if we take all this, we will not be able to cover the text. Almost the same thing which we have covered, he has told in verse form. So that is it. So let us go to Bhrigu Valli Prathamonuvakaha. Then let us read the first mantra. Bhrigurvaivarunihi. I don't have this notations. I will read normally. Varunam pitaram upasasara.
Varunam pitaram upasasara.
Adhihi bhagavo brahmeti.
Adhihi bhagavo brahmeti.
Tasmayetat provacha.
Tasmayetat provacha.
Annam pranam chakshushrotram manovacha miti.
Annam pranam chakshushrotram manovacha miti.
Tagam hovacha. Yato va imani bhutani jayante.
Yato va imani bhutani jayante.
Yena jatani jivanti.
Yena jatani jivanti.
Yat prayantyabhi samvishanti.
Yat prayantyabhi samvishanti.
Tad vijignyasasva.
Tad vijignyasasva.
Tad brahmeti.
Tad brahmeti.
Satapo tapyata.
Satapo tapyata.
Satapas taptva.
Satapastatva.
Iti prathama anuvakaha. So this prathama anuvaka is presenting a small scene before us, a small something like a picture, something like a film shot. It is presenting a shot where one young man, he is going to his father. A young man is going to his father. He is asking his father, "Oh father, tell me what is this Brahma." Normally, if it is something which can be told so easily, any father will tell. It is like revealing the question paper of some MCET examination or some IIT examination. So, the father is the examiner and the son, he is asking him, "My dad, okay dad, you tell me what are the questions." So, the man will happily tell the answers also. But this is something, it is not like an MCET paper or say that IIT paper. So, it is something which the boy has to think for himself. He has to think for himself and he has to realize for himself. This is a travel which you have to travel only. Nobody else can travel for you. He can only guide you. You do this, you go this way, you go this way, but you have to jolly well travel. So that is what we see. So here, there is one gentleman called Bhrigu, one young man. One young man called Bhrigu is the son of Varuna. So that is what, I will tell the meaning first. The shloka, the mantra will see the meaning first. Bhrigurvai Varunihi. Why? Why indeed? Bhrigu, why? Prasiddhi Dyotanartham, that is, it is so well known. So, Bhrigurvai Varunihi, we know that there is a very famous man called Bhrigu, who is Varuna's son. Varunasya Apatyam Varunihi, like Dasharathasya Apatyam Dasharathi. So, it is called Tadhita Pratyaya. Then, Varunam Pitaram Upasasara. Pitaram Varunam Upasasara, he went near the father, who is Varuna. Then he said, Adhihi Bhagavo Brahmeti. Oh, father, you teach me Brahma. Adhihi. Adhihi means you please teach. Adhihi Bhagava. Bhagava means Bhagavan. Hey Bhagavan. Oh Lord. Oh, it is a respectful way of addressing father, addressing a guru. Hey Bhagavan. So that way. Then Tasmai Etat Provacha. Tasmai. To that particular man. Tasmai. Etat Provacha. The father told like this. Etat Provacha. He told like this. What? Annam Pranam Chakshushrotram Mano Vachamiti. You see, the son asked for, "You please tell about Brahma." So the father is saying, "So these are the things which you have to examine." Annam. Annam means not mere food, but annamaya kosha. This annamaya kosha. Pranam. This pranamaya kosha. Then chakshuhu. Chakshuhu is indriya. How these indriyas have come? What is the nature of these indriyas? Not only chakshu, chakshu shrotram. That is, not merely this chakshu and shrotram, but these are the indriyas in general. Then manaha vachamiti, manas and also vak. These things, you examine. What exactly are these jnanendriya and karmendriyas? They have to be examined. And he also said, tam ho vacha, tam ha vacha. It seems he also said like this, tam ha, That is, it seems. Uvacha, Tagumho Vacha, he also said that from which all these beings they come. Yatova Imani Bhutani Jayante. Yataha, Yataha. That from which Yatova Imani Bhutani Jayante. All these Bhutani, all the beings. Imani, that is, all these. When you say this and this, what does it mean? All these means something which are, all these things which are objectifiable, all these things which are drushyam, all these things which fall under the category of drushyam, that is what is the meaning of idam and also imani. These, all these things, that is drushyam, all these drushya vastu, from which all these things they do come, that from which all these things they come. Yena jatani jivanti, all these things they survive on that, they subsist on that, they live on that. Then, yat prayanti abhisamvishanti, yat prayanti, prayanti, pretya, you know the word pretya, in, gatav, eti, then pretya, the same meaning, prayanti, yat prayanti, have departing from here, yat prayanti, departing from here, abhisamvishanti, samvishanti, vishadhatu is, vishapraveshane, praveshati, saha, Kakshayam Pravishati, suppose I say, he enters the room, Vishanti, Pravishanti, here Samvishanti, means Samyak, Vishanti, they enter, they get back. Abhi Samvish, Abhi means towards, Abhi is towards. Abhi Samvishanti, Yat Prayanti, Abhi Samvishanti, yet having departed, they enter the same, that is, all the things they manifest in something, they exist in something for some time, and then they disappear after that. They disappear into the same thing. That is Srushti, Sthiti and Laya. They emerge, appear for some time, they get back into that. Yat prayanti abhisamvishanti tad vijignyasasva. That you know very well. That you have to know very well. Vijignyasasva means you have to know. You please know very well. And then tad brahmeti. That is that Brahma. Here of course there is a question. This footnote here in this Subramanya Shastri's book, there is a footnote which says, it explains, that is one point, an important point it explains. We have seen the Brahma Lakshanam. What is Brahma Lakshanam? Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is the Swarupa. This is the Lakshanam of Brahma. But here of course we are given another definition. It is not what type of definition is it? Yato va imani bhutani jayante, that from which everything appears, that in which everything lives, and into that, that into which all these things they get back or resolve. So that is Brahma. So here, you know the meaning, you know the two words called Swarupa Lakshana and Tatastha Lakshana. You know these two words? Swarupa Lakshana, Tatastha Lakshana. I think we discussed it in some other context. Swarupa is the real nature of a particular thing. Tatastha is a tentative way of describing a thing. Tatastha. Suppose the standard example which is given in our books is Kakavat Devadattasya Gruham. Suppose you have to point out to somebody's house and incidentally there is a crow sitting on that particular house at that particular time. Then you say, oh, that house where that crow is, on which crow is sitting, that is Devadatta's house. Kakavat Devadattasya Gruham. So likewise, suppose you say, oh, you go and then you take a turn, there you will see a big film poster, Chiranjeevi hero. And then you see that film poster, that house. So tomorrow the Chiranjeevi's poster may not be there. That poster may be replaced by some other poster. So that is a tentative definition, but not a regular definition, that not a real Swarupa. So that is why this definition which is given here, it is supposed to be the Tatastha Lakshana, a tentative definition of Brahman, and not the real definition of Brahman. Then why is this tentative definition given? So what he says is, this is for for upasana, knowing this, from this you have to grow on to the earlier level. So one question may arise, okay, we have already seen what is Brahma, we have seen Brahma Vidya and what not, when everything has been told, why again all this thing? Then, okay, this is some sadhana also has to be told. What is Brahma and what happens to that Brahmavit, and what state of enlightenment will he be in, all those things have been described. But at the same time, some sadhanam also has to be told, for a seeker, for somebody who is in that particular path of knowledge, he also has to do some meditations, contemplation, etc. What is that? That has to be told, isn't it? For that purpose, this Tatastha Lakshanam is told here. So that is how this, here this footnote says lakshanadvaya pratipatti lakshanadvaya pratipattihi tatha jagajanma dyupadana nimitta karanam tad brahma iti mithya bhutena api yad rajatam sa shukti ritivat satya brahma lakshanam sambhavati. So anyway, we need not go into all that. So it is enough if you know that srushti sthiti laya is only the tatastha lakshanam of Brahma, and satyam jnanam anantam is the swarupa lakshanam of Brahma. This tatastha lakshanam is being told here only for the purpose of upasana, for the purpose of understanding all these things as not different from Brahma. So that is it. Then eto tad brahmeti sa tapo tapyata. Saha means referring to that Bhrigu, that young man. Tapaha atapyata. Tapas, he did tapas. Did tapas means what? Tapas does not mean any physical austerity, not standing on one leg and standing on a toe and then remaining in fire and things like that. It's not like that. Tapaha, contemplation. He just contemplated. Basically, his father gave him some data. Annam, pranam, chakshu, shrotram, mano, granam. This is the data. This is the laboratory. The mind is your own laboratory. And mind and senses, these are the tools which you are having. And with this thing only you have to contemplate, isn't it? There is nothing else for us to contemplate. So we have to contemplate on the very nature of these sense organs, the very nature of this body, the interdependence of this microcosm on the macrocosm, how this microcosm is not different from that macrocosm. All these things we have to deliberate upon, we have to concentrate, we have to contemplate, and then know the real nature. So that is the point. Sa tapaha atapyata, sa tapas taptva, tva pratyaya, having contemplated, he realizes something which we see in the next anuvaka. So let us see the bhashyam. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma.
Satyam jnanam anantam brahma.
Akashadi karyam annamayantam srushtva tadeva anupravishtam.
Akashadi karyam
annamayantam srushtva
tadeva anupravishtam.
Visheshavadiva upalabhyamanam.
Upalabhyamanam
yasmat
tasmat
sarvakarya vilakshanam adrushyadi dharmakam dharmakameva anandam tadeva ahamasmiti tadeva ahamiti vijaniyat anupraveshasya tadarthatvat tasya evam vijanatah शुभाशुभे कर्मणि जन्मांतरारंभके न भवत इति एवं आनंदवल्यां विवक्षितो अर्थः परिसमाप्ता च ब्रह्मविद्या अतः परं ब्रह्मविद्या साधनम् तपो वक्तव्यम् अन्नादि विषयाणि च उपासनान् युक्तानि इति इत्यतः इदम् आरभ्यते. ओके, सो नाउ शंकराचार्य इज गिविंग ब्रॉड इंट्रोडक्शन. ही इज सेइंग इन द अर्लियर वल्ली द होल ब्रह्म विद्या हैज बीन टॉट, इट हैज बीन टोल्ड कंप्लीटली. सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म, that is, we need not again dwell on that particular Brahma. Then akashadi karyam annamayantam srushtva, it has created all these things, starting from akasha adi, starting commencing with akasha, annamayantam and ending up to annamaya, and beyond annamaya of course there is nothing. Purusha annamaya, this purusha, this being is annamaya, beyond this purusha there is nothing. So pur annamayantam karyam, this is karyam. Starting from akasha to annamaya, this is the karyam, it is the effect. Srushtva, having created. Tadevanu pravishtam, having entered the same thing. It has entered the same thing. That particular Brahma. Then visheshavad iva upalabhyamanam. This iva also is important. Visheshavad iva, as though there is something which is specific. Visheshavad iva. Vishesha means all these worldly things which we see. You see, the samanya is existing and consciousness only. But this existing and consciousness, existence and consciousness is appearing with so many names and forms. Vishesha, all are Vishesha. Vishesha vad iva. Like earlier we saw that one sentence, Vishesha, Visheshe shunye krutva, something like that we saw. So like that, Visheshavad Iva Upalabhyamanam. It is seen, this Brahman is seen as though, say, with great diversity, or say, so much of, say, plurality you see in this world. Plurality and diversity, of course, they are having some social connotations nowadays. Plurality, diversity in society, these are the social connotations. I am not talking about the social connotations, I am talking from a purely philosophical angle. So, these words we have to take in a philosophical angle only. Plurality means the divergence of things, or rather the multiplicity of things. We see so abundant, this, all these things which we see, the multitude of things which we see. So, in that sense, Visheshavad Iva, all these worldly objects, as though in the form of all these worldly objects, it is seen. Upalabhyamanam, yasmat, tasmat, because it is home, because it is so, sarvakarya vilakshanam. So this particular thing, because it is appearing so, then you have to know the truth. Is it the truth or is there something else? You see, that satyam jnanam anantam brahma, it is said to have entered whatever it has created, and it is appearing as so many things. Then we have to see whether it is true or whether it is untrue, and what is the substratum behind them. So that is the point. Tasmat sarvakarya vilakshanam. Something which is distinct from all these karya, sarvakarya vilakshanam, something which is distinct, that which is distinct from all these karyam. Then adrushyadi dharmakam. Adrushya means beyond cognition of senses, not merely seeing, but cognition of all senses. Adrushya, adrushya anatmye, adrushya means beyond sensory perception. Then adrushyadi dharmakam. So the thing which is described as adrushya, anatmya, anilayane, all these things we have to take. Dharmakam, ekameva, dharmakam eva, anandam. That particular ananda, which is Brahman, which is the very thing not different from Brahman. Tadeva aham iti vijaniyat. I am that iti vijaniyat. So that is the thing. I am that iti vijaniyat. So there is an interesting note given by this Vanamalakara. So Vanamalakara says, what is the use of knowing that the same Brahman has become a samsari? You see, this can be looked at this way. This whole thing says, this Brahman, he created it and then he entered it and then he has become a samsari. What is the fun in knowing that? What is it to you or me? The same Brahman has become a samsari. So that is not the meaning. You have to become that. So that is the point. It is not as though that Brahman has become a samsari, but you have to realize that you are not a samsari. So that is the point he says. So Anna Varmalakari writes, Nahi brahmaiva samsaritvam praptam iti jnanat kinchit prayojanam labhete. Nahi brahmaiva samsaritvam praptam iti jnanat. It is the Brahman which has become samsari. By knowing this, na kinchit prayojanam, there is no use at all. Then pratiyamana samsaritva nirasana purvakam. By rejecting or by negating all this world which is seen, which is appearing, then aham brahmeti jnana vivachayam tu muktihi. Your mukti or liberation or it consists in realizing that all this is unreal. That is the point. There is no fun in knowing that Brahma has become a samsari. All this thing is being told not to say that Brahma has become samsari. It is being told to say that you are not a samsari. You realize your real self. So that is the point. So, where are we? Tadevahamiti vijaniyat. So for this he has explained. That is why I say this Vanamala, sometimes it gives a beautiful explanation. Vijaniyat. Anupraveshasya tadarthatvat. Because this anupravesha shruti, it means so. Tadarthatvat. It means so. Then tasya evam vijanataha, for that person, for that evam with, who knows in that particular manner, shubha shubhe karmani, this sadhu asadhu, shubha ashubha, sadhu asadhu, this good and bad deeds, janmantara arambhake nabhavataha, they will not cause him rebirth, they will not, janmantara arambhaka, that is, those which cause the next janma. This punya and papa will fail to do so. Punya and papa will not be able to do so. Nabhavata hait. Ityevam anandavalyam vivachito arthaha. That is the intended, that is the meaning intended to be told. Vivachitaha means vaktumichha vivachha. That is intended, the intended meaning there is that. Then parisamaptacha brahmavidya. And this brahmavidya is something which has been completely told. Then atah param. Atah param means thereafter. Brahmavidya sadhanam. the means for that Brahma Vidya. Of course, earlier also in this earlier Shiksha Valli also we saw some things. But here again some more things are being told. Brahma Vidya Sadhanam. But then there tapas was not told. Tapas is the supreme sadhana. There are many other sadhanas which were told, but this tapas has not been told. Tapaha vaktavyam. Tapa, that Brahma Vidya Sadhanam, tapaha vaktavyam. This about this tapas, about this contemplation, it has to be told. Then annadi vishayani cha upasanani upasanani anuktani ityataha. This annam, pranam, these are the upasana vishayas. Upasana means you have to contemplate more on them. Annam is Brahma, pranam is Brahma, manas is Brahma. So from that, in that manner, he is gradually identifying himself with a higher and higher notion of self. So that is the thing. Upasanani, anuktani, they have not been told. Anuktani, they have not been told. Ityataha, therefore, idam arabhyate, this particular thing is being told. Then, akhyayika vidyastutaye. Is there time? Yeah, there is some time. You got it? Priyaya putraya pitrokteti bhrugurvai varunihi. Okay, akhyayika. Akhyayika means a small episode. You see, in all these Upanishads, now and then episode, you can call it an episode. A particular story, you can say akhyayika, a particular small story or an episode. Vidyastutaye. In order to laud, in order to praise this particular Vidya. Why? Because there is a great Rishi called Varuna, and then his son goes to him. So even though a son asks the father, and even though the son is very, very dear to him, he cannot straight away impart Brahma Vidya to him. So it is something which cannot be imparted straight away, like you impart the knowledge of mathematics or physics. It can't be imparted. It is something which has to be realized. So that is the point. Brahma Vidya Svataye, Priyaya putraya pitrokteti. Pitrokteti means pitra ukta iti. Pitra means by the father, ukta told. By the father it has been told. Iti. Priyaya putraya pitra ukta. Pitra means by the father, ukta it has been told. Akhyayika. Akhyayika pitra ukta. Priyaya putraya iti. Then bhrugurvai varunihi. Vai shabdaha prasiddhanusmarakaha. Bhruguritiyevam nama prasiddho anusmariyate. So this Vai Shabda is to indicate that it is a well-known thing. This particular gentleman was a very famous Rishi. Bhrugur Vai Varunihi. Vai Shabda prasiddha anusmaraka. It is to remind you that it is a well-known thing. Bhruguhu itiyevam nama. A person called Bhrugu. Prasiddhaha. Well-known person. Iti anusmariyate. It is being reminded here. Then Varunihi Varunasya Apatyam Varunihi. Varunam Pitaram. Brahma Vijignyasuhu. Upasasara Upagatavan. It's simple. So he approached his father. Then why Brahma Vijignyasuhu? Jignyasu. Jnatumicha is Jignyasa. One who has Jignyasa is Jignyasuhu. V is only an Upasarga. Vijignyasuhu. Who is a person who is intending to know that Brahman, he approached his father. Then Adhihi Bhagavo.
Adhihi Bhagavo.
Brahma ityanena mantrena.
Brahma ityanena mantrena.
Adhihi. Adhihi means adhyapaya. You please teach me. Hey Bhagava. Bhaye Bhagavan. Adhyapaya. Teach me Brahma. Ityanena mantrena. As told in that particular mantra. Sacha pita.
Sacha pita.
Vidhivad upasannaya tasmai putraya. Etad vachanam provacha. Sacha pita. And that particular father too. Vidhivad upasannaya tasmai putraya. So even that putra seems to have gone to approach his father vidhivat. According to a particular vidhi. As prescribed. So shrotriyam brahmanishtam, samitpani shrotriyam brahmanishtam. Probably in that manner he also went. And then with all sincerity and dedication, He asked his father, Vidhivat Upasannaya, the person who has approached him, Vidhivat, as prescribed, Tasmai Putraya, to that putra, Etad Vachanam Provacha, he told in this particular manner, what? Annam Pranam Chakshushrotram Manovachamiti.
annam pranam chakshu shrotram mano vacham iti
annam
shariram
tad abhyantaram cha pranam attaram upalabdhi sadhanani chakshu shrotram mano vacham ityetani
anantaram upalabdhi sadhanani chakshu
shrotram where is anantaram there is no anantaram pranam attaram after that upalabdhi sadhanani is there anantaram also yeah. It doesn't matter okay that is also
Atta.
What does your book read? Pranam attaram.
Anantara upalabdhi sadhanani.
Okay, fine, fine. That also is good. Upalabdhi sadhanani chakshu shrotram manovacham ityetani brahmopalabdhau dvarani uktavan.
Brahmopalabdhau dvarani uktavan.
Okay. So, annam. What is the meaning of annam? Shariram. Not merely the individual sharira, but the cosmic sharira. We have to see this cosmic sharira also. How this individual sharira is not different from that virat. Cosmic sharira is that virat, isn't it? Cosmic sthola sharira is that virat. So he has to see this annamaya as virat, and this pranamaya as a sutratma, and this annamaya is something which is being eaten by the pranatma. Eaten. This prana or this vital air, what is it doing? It is digesting the food you are giving every day, every morning, afternoon and evening, whatever food we are eating, it is digesting. So, at the cosmos level also, we have seen that there are two items called Agni and Soma. Agni is the fire, this prana, something similar to prana. And then Soma is the food. So, this Agni is always consuming this food. So, Agni Soma, this entire, in the whole universe, this cycle of eater and being, or eaten. Eater and the eaten, that whole cycle goes on in the whole universe. So, that is what it means here. So, that is why it is called Attaram. Atta, you know what is Atta? Adha dhatu. Atta means one who eats. Attaram means dvitiya ekvachanam. So here, what is it? Annam shariram. Tad abhyantaram cha pranam attaram. Tad abhyantaram. More subtle than that. He is that pranam. Pranamaya kosha. Which is Atta. Pranam attaram. Isn't dvitiya vachana. Dvitiya vibhakti. He also told about this Atta. The eater. Pranamaya kosha. At the cosmic level, if you see the sutratma, this sthola sharira, or rather the cosmic thing is the object, this virat. Then sutratma is the enjoyer. Sutratma is the enjoyer. Bhogyam and bhokta, agni and soma. So this one who realizes this, he gets the pleasure. He gets the punyam of agnishthomayaga. So that is what we have read earlier also. So like that. Such a abhyantaram, pranamayam, attaram, upalabdhi sadhana, anantaram cha. Your book is much better, it makes more clear. Anantaram, upalabdhi sadhanani, and later, what did he say? Upalabdhi sadhanani. That is the means to attain. Upalabdhi means to realize. The means to realize. What are they? Chakshuhu, srotram, manovacham, etani. All these things are upalabdhi dvarani. Brahmopalabdhau dvarani. In order to realize Brahman, all these things are like the doors of perception. Dvara is the doors of perception. Then uktvacha, dvara bhutan yetan yannadini, tam bhrugum ho vacha brahmano lakshanam, kim tat, yato yasmadva, imani brahmadini stamba paryantani bhutani jayante. Not stambha, stambha. Stambha paryantani bhutani jayante. Yena jatani jivanti. Pranan dharayanti vardhante. Vinashakalecha. Yat prayanti. Yat brahma prati gachanti. Abhisambishanti. Tadatmyameva pratipadyante. Okay. Uktvacha. What did he say? Having told that chakshu shrotram, etc., having told that uktvacha, dvarabhutani yetani annadini, having told about these things, annam, etc., which are the dvarabhuta, which are like the doors of perception, tam bhrugum ho vacha. He further said, tam bhrugum ha uvacha. He further told his son, brahmanaha lakshanam. He told the definition of Brahma. Again, lakshanam means tatastha lakshanam. Then, what did he say? Kim tat, what is that? Yataha, yasmad va. Yataha, that from which, yasmad va. Imani, Brahmadini Stamba Paryantani Bhutani. You are not only talking about Brahma, say these things which we are seeing. Brahmadi Stamba Paryantani. Starting from that Hiranyagarbha Brahma to a blade of grass. Stamba. Stamba is maybe the cognate word in English, maybe stem. Stem is stamba. Stamba and stem. Stamba is a blade of grass, a small blade of grass, starting from the Hiranyagarbha Brahma, the cosmic mind, down to the blade of grass. Bhutani Jayante. Okay, we'll continue in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.